Hi guys, Joseph Hindle here. This is my second drama school audition vlog of how my experiences are going. Last time I left you off, I had told you that I got to the second round of Royal Scottish and then been unsuccessful. I got to the second round of Central and was still waiting for results. I fell at the first hurdle with Birmingham School of Acting and I got a recall for Manchester School of Theatre. Since then, I have found out my Central result. I was unsuccessful, which I was a little bit disappointed about, but such is life, you've got to move on. Since then, I've had two auditions, one on the 19th of January in Rose Bruford in Sidcup, and one at Drama Centre, which is part of the University of Arts London in Central London, the day after. So it was two quick fire auditions, so I stayed down south in London overnight in a hotel. I also have got my date now for East 15, which is the 23rd of February, and I'm quite surprised that it's so soon, really, because, well, it's not so soon, but it seemed like it. I thought because I was late in getting one of the forms in that I'd be in March or April, but apparently not, which is good, really. So, moving on. Royal Scottish, what am I saying? Rose Bruford and Drama Centre. These two auditions were really a tale of two halves. Like, one went pretty well, one went absolutely appallingly. So, the first one, Rose Bruford in Sidcup. Sidcup is in southeastern Greater London. It's about half an hour away from London on the train. I think it used to be in Kent. I could be wrong, but sorry about that. I'm from the north, I'm ignorant. But yeah, so, it was at the college, it was at Rose Bruford College in Sidcup, and my first impressions when going there, I thought out of all of the schools I've been to so far, it was the nicest looking one. Like, the old house that it used to be situated in is still there, it looks absolutely beautiful. It's situated in a park, I think it's called Lamorby Park or something like that. It's basically in a park, so there's lots of green stuff and it just looks really nice. So yeah, I ended up getting there like an hour early, so I just bummed around in the park for half an hour and then went in, sat in the cafe, chatted to a few people. The audition process at Rose Bruford is a panel audition after a tour. It's not a group audition, it's not an all-dayer, it's not like a long one like Central or Royal Scottish. It's a couple of hours at the most, few hours. Go in, have a tour, and then do your panel audition. And we got the tour first. We were taken around the campus by these two ex-students, and the tour was quite quick. We didn't really go around the entire campus, I think. We were shown the library. We couldn't have been shown the theatres like at Royal Scottish because there were rehearsals going on, so we couldn't go in there. But I got enough to feel quite, I think this is the word, it's a very welcoming campus. It's a very, sorry, I've had a throat problem, which is making me go, which I half blame for one of my auditions going fucking dreadful. Sorry for the swear word. So yeah, where was I? Rose Bruford, welcoming campus, absolutely beautiful place. I feel like I could settle there. It reminds me a lot, just like Royal Scottish, it reminds me a lot of my old, in fact, it reminds me more of my college, my old college, than Royal Scottish did because of all the green sort of suburban aspects to it as well. It reminds me a lot of Runshaw College, which is the college I went to in suburban Leyland. You know, not much going on in Sidcup, but it's a nice enough place and I could settle well there. Because if I was going to drama school every day, then the lack of excitement in Sidcup really wouldn't be that much of a problem. So, Yeah, so the tour was quite quick, quite nice, quite warm and relaxing. And then it was a panel audition. We were sent back to the cafe, then we were called in together in like groups of three. And I was in like the third, I was the first to go in the third group of three. So I went quite early. I was done by 3:30. So yeah, I went in. Oh yeah, we also had a talk with the admissions officer beforehand. He just basically explained the audition process to us. So yeah, then I went in. On the panel, there was one woman who works there, who was nice enough lady, very, very nice. In fact, when I shook her hand, I got static. Now, I don't know what to make of that. Is that a good sign or a bad sign? But I quickly just explained that I have a cough, so hopefully they've taken that into consideration. But I did my speeches. I did Lloyd from Blue Stockings, and I did the Bastard from King John, although I did them the opposite way around that I did everywhere else, because I thought, sorry, see what I mean? So I thought, yeah, I might as well experiment. Because Rose Bruford wasn't that high up in my estimations until I went there, but now it has shot up. So yeah, I did my speeches, and I actually feel they went pretty well. I kept my actioning well all the way through. I feel like my throat didn't play up that much, or if at all. And I just genuinely think they went well. Like at Manchester, I couldn't have been 100% focused again, because I realized that the woman wasn't really writing anything down, which you can take, as I said in the previous, I think I said in the previous vlog, you can take that either way. You can take it as they just flat out think you're shit, or they just think you're good, or, you know, there's no point reading into it at all, really. So yeah, there was also actually one of the students who did the tour was actually sat with her as well, and I'm not sure whether she was pivotal in making a decision either. I'm not entirely sure. I wouldn't be surprised. But yeah, so then after I went, they said, oh, if you've got a recall, the admissions officer will email you directly. If you haven't, then you'll get dirty work from UCAS, basically. UCAS will send. Something has changed. So I've not heard back yet. It's only been about 2 days, but I've not heard back yet. So, like they say, no news is good news. And I really like the college. I feel the audition went rather well. And I hopefully will get a recall there, because I really like the place. Now, the day after, Drama Centre London. I think you know how this is gonna go. Basically, Drama Centre London is part of the bigger University of Arts London, in the central St. Martin's Granary building, which is right next to King's Cross. So, you know, I woke up late in my hotel and I realised I had to check out in like 30 minutes, so I was like, shit. So then, I basically had 2 hours just bumming around London before my audition, which kind of made me worry a bit too much, whereas the Rose Bruford one, I was just up, train, get in, get out, whereas this one, it was sit around in London thinking about shit, because the problem was, I made the massive mistake of not deciding beforehand which modern I was going to use, because Drama Centre London, they let your modern go back as far as 1830. So I'd studied The Seagull by Anton Chekhov for like a whole year at college. So I made the decision back in like October to do Konstantin Trepliev, his first monologue from the play in for Drama Centre. But as it got closer and closer to the day, I started realizing, oh crap, now I feel like I can talk about Lloyd from Blue Stockings better, because he's more in my mind, more recent in my mind. So then I wrote two alternative My Speeches Are sheets and couldn't decide. I only decided at the last minute which one I was going to do, and I decided to do Konstantin Treplev because I just thought, no, just stop overthinking. This is the one you decided a long time ago. Just do it. Yeah, I wish I wouldn't have done that now because it went shit. It went appallingly. I've been swearing too much. It went appallingly. I went in. Unlike Rose Bruford, there was no sort of warming, calm down, initiation session. It was just, come in, do your audition, sit down, wait for the list to go up, because some people get recalled into the afternoon, and then I think they get recalled further, and then I think there's a final recall. And I know Drama Centre is one of the big ones, one of the ones that's pretty close to RADA and LAMDA in terms of its alumni and its training and its funding and everything, but I don't like it. Now, this isn't just me being bitter because I got rejected at the first round, because I went in, I did my speeches, and the problem was my throat played up all the way through Konstantin Treplev. And during the bastard speech, I broke my eye contact with the imaginary kings and looked directly into the eyes of one of the panel. And also my throat played up and I lost my actioning halfway through. So basically everything that could go wrong in the audition did. Now, it's not being me being bitter for being rejected, because I still love Royal Scottish. I still like Birmingham. But Drama Centre was one of those, was probably this school that I got the coldest feeling from. If you know what I mean. I didn't feel welcome there. I didn't feel like they were going out of their way to make us feel comfortable. In fact, the people on the panel didn't even bother coming out the room. They just flicked the blinds to indicate to the student helper that it was time for him to put the next person in. Which I felt, yeah, it's little things like that, but I feel like there was a lack of connection there. They only asked me one question in the interview, so they didn't even give me chance to salvage some brownie points with my interviewing skills, which have dramatically improved since last year. I just immediately thought that they thought I wasn't ready, which, I mean, fair enough, my acting was crap in comparison to my others, but I also did not feel welcome there. At all. Like, it had always been my least favourite from day one. I was so close to swapping it with Italia Conti, but I was talked out of it by several people because they recommended UAL to me, so I thought, fair enough. I think next year I might not even, if I don't get in anywhere, I might not apply to UAL. Now, that doesn't mean you shouldn't apply, because it is a big institution. It's got a great reputation. It's like people like, I think Michael Fassbender went there, and other big names. My mind fails me now. I know Michael Fassbender went there, but it could be right for you. I just don't think it's the right school for me, evidently. Now, they've not officially given me a result yet, but I know I'm not in, because I didn't even get past round one. So, like, out of all the schools, it was such a tale of two halves, this trip to London, because Rose Bruford is the school I've had the warmest reception from this year, and Drama Centre is the one I've had the coldest reception from, and then all the others are somewhere in between. Actually, Man Met is probably joint up there with the warmness with Rose Bruford. Yeah, so that's how it went. Rose Bruford, I feel, went pretty well. Drama Centre was probably the worst audition I have ever done. I just didn't perform on the day. It went worse than my Bristol Old Vic audition last year, which went absolutely appallingly. So, yeah, like, thanks for watching again. If you want to hear me waffle on about, if you've not watched the first one and you want to hear me waffle on about Royal Scottish and Birmingham and Man Met and Central and how those schools are and how I pick my speeches and everything, then just you can watch the first video. It's 40 minutes long, but I've put in the description the times of each new topic. Now, what I've got to do from here is I feel like I should find myself another modern monologue, which is going to be hard, but I need some sort of backup monologue because I don't feel like I want to do Constantin Treplev again. So I need to find myself another modern monologue for my Manchester Metropolitan recall in March, and maybe if I get a Rose Bruford recall, I'd need it. Yeah, and the next audition is Lambda, a regional Lambda audition in on January the 31st, which I've just found out there's no trains going to Manchester that day. So you have to get a bus, so I'm going to have to set off like really freaking early. And then the day after, I'm probably going to have to go to a hotel in Manchester, because the day after I have RADA regional in Manchester. So, yes, that's what I've got to do, and that's what's happened. Thank you for watching, and see you later. Peace.